Welcome back. As we continue to shiver through winter, you could be excused for thinking a short holiday somewhere warmer would be a good idea. Well, why not Bali? As David O'Shea reports, that tropical island that so many Australians love is now so popular that, according to many of the locals, their very way of life is under threat. Here's David.
This is the Bali that tourists flock to see. But this year, the tiny island will be besieged by more than 10 million visitors, almost three times the local population. It's a huge stress on resources, for land to build hotels and private villas, for water to service them, and for somewhere to put all the rubbish. Environmental activist Moko is taking me to a site that's not on the tourist trail.
Jadi ini namanya gunung apa nih?
Ini gunung sampah. Kalau zaman dulu anak-anak bisa mungkin menggambar mataharinya tumbuh dari balik gunung dan gunungnya warnanya hijau, mungkin hari ini gunungnya adalah gunung sampah.
Many thousands of cubic meters of waste is dumped here every day. The toxic runoff filters into the groundwater, which is the source of much of South Bali's drinking water.
Artinya kita sedang secara langsung diracuni oleh tumpukan sampah ini.
Ketut. With no real action by the government to address the garbage problem, Australian Mike O'Leary formed a foundation to promote environmentally sustainable development. It's a small effort, but one he hopes will eventually lead to a change in mindset.
So here you can see we do many waste management and pickups, beach cleanups and stuff. Everyone in the local community is allowed to drop their waste here if they want. So here we teach the importance of separation to your plastic recyclables, your plastic non-recyclables, paper, cardboard, metals.
For O'Leary, garbage is not the only problem. He says Bali's development is based on exploitation.
So that's the Ritz-Carlton?
Yeah, that's the Ritz-Carlton. It just goes on and on and on. And you've got like 3,000 underpaid workers here, living in shanty towns. Come on, we'll go in. See how they live. Yeah, this is like something back in the dark ages. These billion dollar deals, and you don't think that they could look after them a little bit better? Have a look at the waste under here.
His foundation also runs a micro project teaching traditional weaving. It's an attempt to address the lack of opportunity for those without the education and language skills to find employment in the booming tourism sector.
Dulu saya penanam rumput laut, tapi karena sekarang udah banyak proyek, rumput lautnya nggak aktif lagi, udah rusak semua.
Karena apa?
Karena limbah-limbah dari hotel itu terbuang ke laut, semua karang-karang, rumput lautnya itu semuanya mati.
Many Balinese now believe that keeping culture and tradition strong could well be their last defence. Every year, hundreds gather at this sacred temple to pay homage to their ancestors. Possessed by their spirits, some enter a deep trance. Ceremonies like this cement key Balinese values of living in harmony with each other, with God, and with the natural world. The holy water sprinkled on devotees plays a vital ceremonial role. This gift from the gods is also a crucial life-giving force in this rice-based culture. Water for rice paddies is delivered through this ancient and very efficient canal system called the subak. It's so important to Balinese culture, it was World Heritage listed in 2012, because with all the development, it's under threat.
Kalau tidak ada air, otomatis kita akan mati semua. Gitu. Tolong sumber air, mata air itu jangan semua diambil, dinaikkan untuk menjadi dijual ke hotel-hotel. Itu permohonan kami.
Di atas ada banyak hotel?
Banyak juga, banyak di atas, banyak hotel. Sehingga mata air kita ini sudah diambil, sudah dinaikkan sebagian. Gitu. Nah kalau bisa, yang sekian itu jangan diambil lagi. Gitu.
The water in this canal irrigates almost 50 hectares of communal rice paddy. The competition for water is one thing. Keeping productive land in Balinese hands is another. Rather than constantly struggling against developers, many farmers simply sell their land to them. With prices skyrocketing 1,000% in the past 5 years, it's hard to resist.
We're very glad to see you here at the second Indonesian Hotel Investment Conference. The response has grown each year, I think, as the property market continues to grow in Bali. Welcome to the stage, please, if you would, Ibu Wiryanti Sukamdhani.
Sukamdhani is owner of a hotel chain, a member of parliament, and head of the Indonesian Hotel and Restaurant Association.
Our target for the foreign tourists in 2014 is 9.3 million. Bali is always very interesting because it's going to be 67 new hotels. I don't know anymore where those hotels will be built, you know, because we don't have rice field anymore.
There are many here today that have cashed in on Bali's tourism boom. But former tourism minister I Gede Ardika tries to sound a warning.
The tourism industry, don't be greedy.
He reminds the conference of the United Nations Millennium Goals set for Indonesia.
Basically, what the UN expect from us is shift of paradigm in development.
Applying UN goals to limit development seems like a lost cause. There is no better example than the Benoa Bay Land Reclamation Project in the heart of the tourist south. It's a controversial plan to dredge the bay, then build and develop 9 islands in an integrated tourism park over 800 hectares. Gendo Swadana is leading a coalition opposed to the development.
Apakah keyakinan yang benar? Apakah mereka yang pro reklamasi atau kita yang berdiri dengan tegak menolak reklamasi ke Benoa?
Seperti ini master plan-nya. Hotel villa, 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 villa apung, villa apung, villa, villa, hotel resort, apartemen, apartemen, perdagangan, mall, mall, ya, kemudian K ini baru kantor, ini perdagangan, ini G kami curigai golap. Tapi dia bilang ini lahan hijau.
We need jobs. We need new icons of tourism in Bali.
Bali's governor, Made Pastika, who as police chief played a key role investigating the Bali bombings, is an enthusiastic supporter of the land reclamation.
We have to widen our area. We have to widen. That's a must. Everywhere in this world they are doing that. Singapore, Hong Kong. I don't think Australia also, I think. Even though Australia is still very wide. But everybody want to widen their area. Why not? As long as it's not against the environmental, it will not damage the environment.
But Benoa Bay is a designated conservation area. So there's a push to get the president to sign a regulation removing that status.
Caranya adalah ubah dia dari kawasan konservasi ke pemanfaatan umum. Dan ini yang paling berbahaya bulan-bulan ini. Karena ada agresivitas luar biasa dari pemerintah.
Sekarang ini?
Ya, sekarang ini untuk mengubah kawasan konservasi menjadi kawasan pemanfaatan umum. Mereka mau mengubah perpres.
And even within the tourism and development community, there's concern about the project.
But the point is, you know, that it's damaging the environment, you know. So that's not the answer. The answer to me is that you have to really control the building, control how many hotels, how many rooms, you know, without damaging the environment. So by reclaim, that's only damage.
Governor Made Pastika has been the subject of intense criticism because of an open letter he wrote 3 years ago calling for a moratorium on hotel construction in South Bali. Some of your critics say that you broke your own rules by then supporting some hotel development projects. What would you say?
No, I never broke my rule. I never allow people building new accommodations, you know, especially in the southern part of Bali. You know, that letter is an appeal. I don't have the authority to stop that.
He doesn't do what he already promised on what he already planned. In the area which is supposed to be preserved, then he give a license to build a new one. So, I mean, this is really not consistent, you know, inconsistent.
But in this plush hotel owned by the main developer behind Benoa Bay, I find a vocal supporter of the project. Businessman Made Manku says reclamation goes on in plenty of other places like Queensland, so why not here?
Sama seperti Gold Coast yang ada di Australia, di mana juga Australia juga mereklamasi Gold Coast. Tetapi daerah itu kenapa juga tidak diteliti lebih mendalam, kemudian ada nggak cara yang lain untuk tidak mereklamasi? Kenyataannya Gold Coast menjadi luar biasa, menjadi bagus banget. Kita harus membangun, Pak. Ya, kita tidak boleh tidak membangun. Tetapi apakah Bali kemudian kalau ada orang-orang yang tidak setuju untuk Bali ini dibangun, kita ini akan terus seperti ini. Kita akan terus menjadi orang yang keterbelakang. Kita akan terus akan menjadi orang miskin.
Just a few days after this interview, a presidential regulation was issued, removing the conservation area status and allowing so-called revitalization in Benoa Bay. The brand new toll road has just opened and will get visitors from the airport to their floating villa in no time at all. Around the southern part of the bay, the area to be most affected, the protest flags are flying.
These are stored here.
Dive and marine sports operator Ian Nyoman Sugita only set up shop here 3 years ago. He's now facing ruin.
It's gonna kill my business. It's gonna kill it. It's not just only my business. It's still a turn up the local economy sector. Like, they're gonna kill all the reef, the fish, the coral. It's all gone. It's gonna destroy this area.
He says the secrecy surrounding the project is unacceptable.
Until now, they never show up, never talk to me personally, and what they want to build it is going to impact to my little business here or not.
Yeah, I'm just thinking about the future of Bali. Every year we have more than 25,000 students from the university. They will graduate, they will need jobs, and where are they going to do that?
But for many, stopping people selling their land is the key issue.
We're going to see this guy, Sayur, who is an artist.
Activists Wayan and his colleague Phyllis Kaplan, who are working to protect the rice farmers, are taking me to meet one landowner who's holding out against developers.
Hello.
Nice to see you.
Yeah.
I love the paintings.
Yeah.
Especially what it says here in relationship between money, development, and farmers. Mm-hmm. Can we see some more of the paintings?
Yeah. Please.
Sayur's paintings are a plea from the bugs and the animals to not build on productive land.
Jadi, biar ibarat ada kodok, ada bebek, yang semuanya itu adalah
perwakilan dari makhluk-makhluk yang sawah yang kini mempertanyakan ketika vila telah datang, terus profesi petani sekarang udah berubah menjauh. Ya, ibarat dia mempertanyakan itu. Ya, ini.
He's best known for one bold art installation. He put up this huge sign on his own block.
Sawah adalah pertahanan terakhir saya. Jadi makanya not for sale itu saya dirikan. Makasih banyak ya.
With a rapidly growing domestic market and a surge in Chinese package tourism, Bali's boom seems set to continue.
We Balinese should take the move to save Bali. If not us, who else? If not now, when? Before it's too late. Bali is so small and we don't have time to playing around.
David O'Shea and the battle for Bali. And with Bali such a popular destination for Australians, we'd love to hear your views on that story. Use the Dateline SBS hashtag on Twitter or go to our website to tell us what you think. You'll also find links there to some of the people featured in David's piece.